Last of all, let me tell you the story about Puff, the magic dragon.
Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Little Jackie Paper, he loved that rascal Puff and brought him strings and sealing wax and other fancy stuff. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Together they would travel on a boat with billowed sail. Jackie kept a lookout perched on Puff's gigantic tail. Noble kings and princes would bow whene'er they came. Pirate ships would lower their flag when Puff roared out his name. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. A dragon lives forever, but not so little boys. Painted wings and giant strings make way for other toys. One grey night it happened, Jackie Paper came no more. And Puff, that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. His head was bowed in sorrow, green scales fell like rain. Puff no longer went to play along the cherry lane. Without his lifelong friend, Puff could not be brave. So Puff, that mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolly. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist